Hey, what's good, everybody? We just got our full team of the week reveal. So I want to go over the players, and then we're also going to go ahead and take a look at the wide receiver market. This team of the week, in my opinion, is very good. So let's jump right into it. And then I want to show you a little clip of something we pulled. And so let's jump into it. Team of the week full reveal. As you can see, our limited edition is Joey Bosa. Now, I know that the director is probably super pumped about this specific card, but it seems like the Niners and the Chargers are just taking W's when it comes to their theme teams. But this card looks pretty good. He comes in at 80 speed, 88 acceleration, 87 strength, 86 tackle, 93 play rec, which play rec this year seems to me like it really matters more than years past. Also, he has 78 block shed, which is on the low side, but then he has 89 power move mixed with 94 finesse move. Now, with a power up, you're going to be able to get that up to a 90 power move and 95 finesse move. Now, finesse move, in my opinion, works super good this year. You know, I have Elvis Dumerville, who has very high finesse move, but has very low block shed, and he has okay power move. It seems like those cards, they do great at the pass rush, and they're always getting to the quarterback. Now, this card will obviously get edge threat, but you even look at other high finesse move players like J.J. Watt. J.J. Watt has very high play rec, but he also has very high finesse move. So it seems like the finesse move when it comes to pass rush is a problem this year. So this card, I think, is going to be very good, especially with 80 speed. You power that up to 81 speed, you add some sort of a sprinter, you add some sort of a brawler, you're at 81, and on the theme team, 82, that's not bad coming off the edge. So our LTD is Joey Bosa. Now, this is the card I'm excited for, and this is the card that I thought would happen, and what I really like what EA is doing. You know, last year, whenever we would, there was really no formula. It would almost seem like they would just pick somebody, and every now and then they'd pick a good player that actually performed. But it seems like this year, the player of the week is actually the player that really goes off. And Tyler Lockett, if you watch that Seahawk game, the Seahawk Cardinals game, this man got off. I want to say he had 17 receptions, and then he also had somewhere in the neighborhood of 200 yards and 3 touchdowns. Tyler Lockett has been getting off. This card is very well deserved. He clocks in at 92 speed, 83 jumping, 92 catching, 86 catch in traffic, 90 spec catch, 86 short route running, 87 medium route running, and 89 deep route running. Now, in anticipation, we currently have Chase Claypool, who is 94 speed on our team. We also have Odell Beckham, who's also 94 speed on our team. But what we've done is we're selling Odell Beckham. We might even sell Chase Claypool to get this card. This card, powered up, you're going to get him to a 93 speed. On our team, we have Brawler, so he'll have a 95 speed. This is going to be a very speedy wide receiver, one that I look to add to the squad. He may probably go for about 350K to start, maybe even four. But whenever you have cards like this, I want to say that packs have value. So you know we're going to be ripping packs, especially our pack value has been pretty good on Team of the Week. And remember, you still need these cards, the 82, 83s, and the 86s, to make the team standouts. So packs today will have value. All right, moving on. Will Shields. This one's kind of off. First lineman that we've got on Team of the Week. But linemen are people too, and we need them in the game. So this one's pretty good. He has a 91 run block, and then he also has 88 pass block. So if you have any type of go deep, if you have play fake, you're going to be able to get that up. So that looks pretty good. And then we have Rodney Harrison, 91 overall. A little underwhelming, unless he's on a theme team, Patriots or Chargers, but 89 speed, 90 acceleration, 90 tackle, 90 play rec, 75 man coverage, 89 zone coverage, and 90 power. So somewhat of a balanced card. It looks decent. And then one thing I did forget to say, that when it comes to like Tyler Lockett, We have play fake. So we have 45-45 play fake, which gives you plus 4 on short route running and medium route running. So he's going to hit all route running thresholds. So that car is going to be a glitch. Now, we're going to compare some wide receivers to see what knowledge of him coming out has done to the market. But before we do that, let me show you this clip. So Sunday night, we were up late. We were playing weekend league, and we got DC glitched. So I was upset. And you know what? It's you're late. You do some stupid things. So I never open legend fantasy packs. I absolutely hate these packs. But I said, you know what? 120K coins, let's do it. Let's open a pack. So we opened a pack. We were trying to pull Joe Montana. Joe Montana was going for over 600K. So I thought to myself, let's do it. What can it hurt? So we pull this card. We see Volts. And we pulled limited edition Khalil Mack. Now, what's interesting about this is this had to have been an EA mess up because he was technically supposed to be out of packs Saturday morning, but he was obviously in packs and I had seen a lot of people pulling him. So we ended up pulling him. I thought I'd share that with you. Secret pool. Let's go ahead real quick and we're gonna go ahead and look at what the market looks like in terms of wide receivers. So let's take a look real quick. We're gonna look at Odell Beckham first. And we're going to, so his price is already coming down. So he was 230 yesterday, and right now he's already dropping. Everyone's selling him. He's selling for about 190. So let's go ahead and take a look at Chase Claypool. Chase Claypool is going for, let me take a look. Which this might be a decent, you know, whenever you're replacing players, one of the things you want to do is you want to make sure that you try to sell a player, right, to try to recoup some of your coins. But let's take a look at what the wide receiver market looks like right now. This is good for us because what's going to happen is we anticipate scary fast most feared to come out this Friday. So these cards, you'd imagine, are probably going to come down in price because we're probably going to get a Randy Moss, maybe a Tyreek Hill. You never know. Maybe a Calvin Johnson. Well, let's take a look. Reggie Wayne is down to 120. Adam Thielen has come down a little bit. Brandon Cook's down to 190. He's been going for that price pretty steadily. And what's Chase Claypool? 298. So Chase Claypool came down. He was going for about 340 yesterday. We made him for 230. So if we sell him, we're going to be okay. And our Chase Claypool looks pretty good. And we went with Chase Claypool. Let me just throw this little tidbit in here. So Calico, I've heard, is the best wide receiver in the game. He's going for 280 right now. Oh, when weekend league starts, he's normally goes for somewhere in about 350. But this card looks pretty good. Now, when you compare him to Chase Claypool, pretty similar, right? Powered up Calico and him are both 92 speed. Everything is pretty similar, 90 route running. Now, Calico may play a little different, but Calico is a little more expensive. Now, for us, what we did, and I'm throwing this out there again, you're going to hear me say it over and over and over again. Really look into possibly making the switch from go deep to play fake, because play fake boosts both your medium route running and short route running. So if we look at our Chase Claypool, the reason we went with him over Calico is because he, on our team, since we have 40-40 baller, he has 94 speed, 93 catching, 92 short route running, 91 medium route running, and 90 deep route running. So expect the wide receiver market to fall a little bit today. And I will say this, on Friday, when we get scary fast, I think that the market on wide receiver is going to go down. So if you have your eye on someone like Brandon Cooks, Odell Beckham, Calico, or Chase Claypool, depending on who they put out, expect wide receiver market to come down. So this might be a good time to save some coins, sell some players. I'm not saying to sell your squad. Be very careful with that. So don't say I said that. But for us, we already, we're able, based off of the team that we have, we're going to sell Odell Beckham, and we're probably going to sell Chase Claypool, to be very honest with you, because I can get away with my Andre Johnson, Jerry Rice, and Tyler Lockett. So I'll have a 95 speed, and Andre Johnson on our team has 92 speed. Vernon Davis has 92 speed, and then we can prepare for scary fast. So that's all that I got for you. Expect us to come back around at 11 o'clock, and we will open some packs. So good luck. Be great today. It's E2 Times. Like and subscribe. Until next time, peace. We're out.